Welcome back. Now, I'd like to share with you a practical aspect of what we just discussed in what to expect from your first meeting with a professional. I had a very challenging first meeting. In fact, my team did a very challenging first meeting with a prospective client. We did business with a young professional. And we all got along and everything was great. And, you know, it was just the perfect professional client relationship. And one day she called me up and she said, "Pat, would you mind interviewing my parents to possibly take on as clients? I know that someday I'm going to be responsible for their investment assets. And quite frankly, I have zero time for their advisors. And I really think they would be much better suited working with you and your team. But I have to warn you, my dad is very set in his beliefs." So I said, "Okay, all right." So we set up the date and in they came. Now, when we got to the risk tolerance part of the meeting, it was abundantly clear why she said he was set in his ways. Behavioral biases and beliefs based on emotion rather than on reality are very, very hard to avoid and to overcome. And this particular gentleman, who is well into retirement now, was utterly convinced by the false belief that the cash flow that his portfolio produced was indeed his return on investment. His portfolio was 97% bonds, and an awful lot of those bonds were junk bonds, which means lower quality and at risk of going into default. And indeed, he even had some bonds that were in default that had not paid for some time and had next to zero value. So we went through the risk tolerance questionnaire and we tried to guide him as to the outcome of the answers that he was giving. This did not shake his behavioral bias nor his emotional beliefs that were false. So we tried a second exercise to get at the same thing. And then we did a third exercise to again try to get to the risk tolerance. Finally, I had to show him that his portfolio had declined in value for the past 3 years, despite the cash flow. This came as a total and utter shock. Now, his wife had been sitting there through this whole meeting, and she had been very silent because she was definitely of the generation that said, "My husband handles the money, and I just listen. I do not participate." So that was the fact that she was silent was not a surprise. What was a surprise was that she suddenly burst out and said, "Our advisors are idiots." We were stunned to silence in this meeting. She had hit the nail on the head. And it was interesting because once the husband could get his arms around the relationship between what it is you're trying to achieve and the risk tolerance connection to the average rate of growth towards what it is you're trying to achieve, then And only then did he see his portfolio in a whole new light. So these meetings are important, and I would urge you to watch our videos on what to expect. Now, you can follow us on both our website listed below, where it's very interesting that you can go and read the bios on each of the professionals that appear on this show, as well as on YouTube, and reference prior videos for things that we have discussed in the past, things like the 10 things you need to know to grow your first million, the core and satellite investment strategy, what makes investing different for women than men. You know, we have some really great videos, and I would urge you to subscribe to our channel. And if you'd like, hit the bell so you can be told when a new show is being posted. Thank you very much. And remember that on Investment Questions, we discuss the things that you really need to know in order to grow, protect, and ultimately distribute your net worth. Thank you.